patients, it may be research field. I'm very, very happy and privileged to introduce my classmate and good friend, that is Dr. Winston Varghese. Winston Varghese, my memories goes in 1985 when we came together. He was a very simple, very innocent, and I can say it's, he was involved in almost all the activities. He was receiving everything. In fact, I was a senior to him in my age and my qualification. So we used to mend him, and he used to accept everything. That is the beauty of this person. In the last 30 years, I have not seen that quest for trying to know something more. That is with Dr. Winston Varghese. And he has also grown in the same way, because you are trained by Dr. M.L. Dawle in such a way that we should be a part of this system, taking care of the academic, taking care of the clinical, as well as research. I'm sure that he has done justice to this particular dream of the vision of our founder in this particular SCR system, Dr. M.L. Dawle. I'm very happy to introduce him. And you all know, he has now completed 50 years. He is in the Golden Jubilee year. And 1991, he passed out from Father Muller's, and we are all together. In 2006, he got his MD in Material Medica from Vinayaka Mission's Deemed University. And he is the professor and PG coordinator of Sharada Krishna Homeopathic Medical College, Kulasekaram, Kanyakumari district. Now, he is a keen learner, I said. He attends almost all the, the courses that participation in ROTP programs, CME programs, conferences. He makes it a point from the beginning, and he also encourages his students to attend almost all the programs. That is how you can see the Sharada Krishna, the postgraduate students. I am sure the students who passed up from Sharada Krishna and also postgraduate students, they realize his, motivational, spirit in that institution. He is also a resource person for so many CMEs, and for the certain things I will narrate. CME for medical officers and practitioners of homeopathy in respiratory diseases, lifestyle disorders, gastrointestinal disorders. He is also, the workshop, conducts a workshop for education technology. He's a resource person for CME at Kolkata, then in Chennai, Belgaum, Palghar, Maharashtra, and national seminar at his own institution. He has published his articles in journal, A Case of Lichen, Homeotimes, A Case of Tropic Ulcer, A Case of Diabetic Ulcer, A Case of Cellulitis Necrosis, A Case of Ulcer Diabetes or Miasm. He has got a passion for this treatment of these one-sided and conditions which are having the expressions. He had also involved himself in presenting the poster presentations in two of his posters, and efficacy of certain endophytic fungi against Spodoptera littera International Conference on Biocontrol Sustainable Insect Management by Tamil Nadu Agriculture University in the year 2018. Impact of the commercial entomopathogenetic fungi on plant growth parameters in International Conference on Biocontrol Sustainable Insect Management by Tamil Nadu again in January 2018. He has published books, A Guide to Cervical Spondylosis, Monograph of Lachesis, Revisited Augmented Materia Medica of Dr. Benoit Muret, Question Bank of Second Year Students, A Compendium on Homeopathic Management of Ulcers, A Calcarea Group, Herpetolithiasis and Homeopathy, A Handbook of Psoriasis, Condensed Key to Materia Medica by Postgraduates, Therapeutic Symposium of Materia Medica by Postgraduates. What more you require to know about involvement of an individual in the academic field? He is also involved in research. You might have heard that when the CCRHS announced for the students' research projects, Sharada Krishna always is in the forefront. They have got, in almost all the years, they have got good number of students who are taking participated, and their research projects are accepted. Reason, this man is also into research, an experimental study to evaluate the role of homeopathic medicine, plus toxicodendron and Bryonia alba in varying level of serum heparinic synthetase in patients suffering from osteoarthritis. He also is funded by the Tamil Nadu MGR Medical University. He has completed his project as a principal investigator. And second is the effect of calcarea carbonic on osteoporotic activities in overectomized albino rat model of osteoporosis in 1x30 and 0.1 potencies, funded by Global Homeopathy Foundation as guide. Guided 17 dissertations in MD home students. And other activities, of course, as a teacher, as a PG coordinator, he has taken up all the responsibilities. He's a resource person for the various teachers' training seminars as well as the national seminars. He is a key person in almost all the activities of Sharada Krishna Homeopathic Institution. I know that institution when I visited that particular place when he was there, and now how much it has grown. Along with all the people from his college, he has made it a point to take it to the greater heights. He's also a recipient of the Best Faculty Award from Institution of Homeopaths Kerala. And he was also awarded the Best Scientist Award for his work on scientific collections. With these words of introduction, I present to you all my dear friend, a researcher, academician, and a clinician par excellence, Dr. Winston Vergis. Dr. Winston Vergis, over to you. Welcome.
Thank you, Dr. Shiva Prasad. I would call you only Shiv because that is the way in which I have called you. Okay. And once I'm coming back to, I have the sensation, I have the feeling that I am back again to the institution. I remember the long days, the long walks which we used to take, from Kanganadi to that bridge, our bridge, all that coming to my memory. Okay, thank you so much for that big introduction you have given, very big introduction. Thank you. And first of all, let me thank all the other organizers, who have been vital in bringing this program. So today my topic is management of ulcers. See, this ulcer is a major problem in homeopathy because as a definition, the ulcer, what an ulcer means is a breach of continuity of epithelium, either of skin or mucous membrane. Now, the breach of mucous membrane is not visible for us because usually this is internal. So, none of us are bothered about it, and it does not give much trouble as it is a breach of skin. And the breach of skin is visible, so people are more bothered. And this is most of the time painful also. That's why patients come to homeopathic treatment. Many of the time, why they come for homeopathic treatment is that they get fed up with other treatment. That's why they come for homeopathic, or they come to a stage where they cannot afford for further treatment. They come for homeopathic treatment in ulcers. So classification of ulcers, this is a pathological, we classify as vascular. Either it could be arterial or venous or neurogenic ulcer or infective ulcer, bacterial or fungal or traumatic or neoplasm. So I will take up a few cases belonging to this. Let us go ahead. I will present a case, then we will make it as an interactive session as how we will deal with it, and finally we will conclude. My time is 1 hour. Am I right, Shiv? Yeah. So let us go ahead.
1.5 hour time is there, yeah.
1.5 hour. Okay, yeah. Then we'll make it a little more. This one. So this is about Mr. C, aged 67 years, from Kootappanaithar, Nelveli, presented with a painful ulcer in the left foot since 3 months. Pain is aggravated in night. He has also got numbness of the lower extremity, especially at night. This gets worsened while walking and lying on sides. So this is ulcer. You have seen that ulcer. So whatever you see here is a bone. What you are seeing with the bone is exposed. Metatarsal bone is exposed. This is how the patient presented with. A further close-up look of that. The patient is a known diabetic since 3 years. how that history, how it evolves. 3 months before, he got injured on the left little toe and took some herbal external application. But his condition worsened and went to allopathic hospital nearby his house where the toe was amputated. Patient developed a gangrene over the amputated site and referred to Chennai hospital, where it was diagnosed as a vascular obstruction and advised to undergo vascular surgery, which requires nearly 8 hours of anesthesia. Now, one of these son got very much worried about 8 hours of anesthesia for this elderly person, and he went and asked the doctor, "Doctor, whether my father will withstand this?" So he told, "If he withstand, well and good." And the son asked, "If he does not withstand?" "Oh, that we cannot assure." So with this complaint, the pathologist of him is at the age of 13 years, he has developed a chickenpox. 32 years of age, had a fracture of leg. And 64 years of age, he was operated for cataract. And family history, brother and mother, diabetic, brother and father, hypertensive. Another brother is insane. And another brother is having a bronchial asthma. So from this, you will be able to understand how the miasmatic influence, almost all the miasms are there. And the syphilitic miasm is very high in him. He is a non-vegetarian. And the worst thing, his personal history says that smoking 35 to 40 cigarettes per day. Consumes alcohol every day, but since 2 months has stopped consuming alcohol. Appetite diminished, thirst increased for cold water, sleep disturbed due to pain, stool regular, urine increased frequency to pass at night, sweat increase over head and chest, desire cold food and drinks, sweets and alcohol is his disease. And an arterial Doppler study was done by the hospital where he was to be admitted, Chennai Hospital. Done on this one says lower limb reveals that severe atherosclerotic peripheral vascular occlusive disorder. Entire left superficial femoral artery shows long segment narrowing with irregular endimal thickening with the luminal thrombus formation causing near total 90% to 98% of arterial occlusion with the absence of spontaneous spontaneous flow. See that the depth of pathology and depth of damage, 90% to 98% of vascular obstruction. And MRI angio was also done. And, there is an occluded segment measuring about 20 centimeters. Okay, that is what it says, leg says. So this is also, the left leg is also involved. And finally, the diagnosis, dry gangrene with the peripheral vascular occlusive disease and diabetes mellitus. Anyone who want to respond, how do you want to manage the case? Whether they are allowed to interact in between?
I can put it in a chat box.
Yeah.
They can answer it in chat box. Questions, they can interact through chat box.
I am not able to see anything coming. Okay, let me go ahead.
Yeah, yeah, you can go ahead. And if they want to, because we don't open this mic, sir.
Yeah, yeah, that's a good thing.
Okay.
So now this is what is a repertorial totality you just taken. Because, we see so many, apart from the atraumatic changes which were there and in the leg, there were also atraumatic changes which were seen. Yeah, pathological prescription. Good. treatment ulcer followed by constitutional treatment. Very good. Somebody put up that sulfuric acid, arsenic album, Cali bike. Very good. So things are coming up now. Nice. So what we have seen is that. So this was a what you call repertorial totality which was taken, because so much of atherosclerotic changes, not only in his limb, it was there in the aorta, it was there in the, other vessels also. So what we have taken, circulation, blood vessel, heart, sclerotic, thickened. So we have referred this, what is a repertory was a Boger-Bönninghausen was taken up. And skin, exterior of body, gangrene cold, skin exterior of the body, ulcer gangrenous, skin exterior of body, ulcer sensitive, appetite, desire for alcoholic liquors, appetite, desire sweet, appetite, desire cold liquid and water, condition general, aggravation time night, lower extremity numbness. This was taken as a rubrics and repertorization was done. And these are the medicine which came up. Arsenic album, China, Mercurius, Arnica, Lactasis, Sulfur and Silesia. Finally, arsenic album was selected and the treatment started with arsenic album 0/3 QDS. Then the potency was raised to 0/6 and 0/12. Over a period of 6 months, patient showed improvement in ulcer and diabetes also. Now you will be able to see the accessory management which has been done. The diet was modified in such a manner, the patient is asked to consume a lot of fresh green vegetable salads and sprouted material. As the patient was already on insulin, it was allowed to be continued after strict monitoring of urine sugar. Patient was admitted to IP for a period of 3 months. Then he was allowed to go to his home. The wound was dressed with the calendula glycerin twice. Then it was made into once a day. And this was a period. We also removed all the slough. Okay, every day we used to remove the slough. And see now the bone also, we have nibbled the bone with the help of surgeon. We have nibbled the bone because an osteolytic area would always won't heal. So that osteolytic area was nibbled by a help of a surgeon. He has nibbled the bone. While nibbling the bone, there was so much of bleeding. So what that surgeon wrote back to us is the vascularity is adequate. Very interesting after homeopathic treatment. And we have brought to this state and finally to this state. So this is a case of a vascular ulcer. Okay, with the diabetes mellitus. So let us go to the next case. Okay, case 2, Mr. K, aged 35 years, address, he belongs to Kulashekaram, and this is a case number of him. On 17/9/04, he presented with a complaint of non-healing ulcer since 2 years over the left heel. The ulcer is punched out and very offensive. See, the offensiveness is like that. At that time, we used to have our dressing and all done in the top floor. And the lower floor is a dispensing area. So when we opened the ulcer in the top floor, people who were standing in the ground floor, they were closing their nose. So much offensive. In spite of, there is there is no pain. The ulcer started after the patient has got out of bed and started using his leg after a paraplegia, which was followed after he has fallen in a well and injured the spinal cord. So there was a history of spinal cord injury and the patient was bedridden for some time. And then he started walking. He developed the ulcer in the heel. See, this is what is a ulcer in the heel, what you are able to see. There is a white area is there. Okay. So that white area is nothing but the calcaneus bone you are able to see. And this is a punched out ulcer what you are able to see. Okay, this is another view of the ulcer. So, and a small ulcer in the medial side. He also has got incontinence of urine and prolapse of rectum following the injury to spinal cord. Along with this complaint, he had fullness of the abdomen and flatulence, which get aggravated after farinaceous food. Past history, there was asthma in childhood, which gets aggravated during monsoon, moon phases, and cold exposure. And he has changed his residence. This problem spontaneously got settled. Family history, asthma for his brother and one of his sister, and rheumatism in mother. And physical generals, increased sweat over the palm and soles, and thermally he has aversion to both extremes of temperature and prefers fan in summer. Prefers covering in all the season with moderately thick cloth and desires cold water bathing. There is a craving for fish and pungent things. Mentally, he is a very optimistic and easily get irritated while being contradicted. He was also having artistic talent, including stage performance of drama and music concert. Has got a very sharp memory. On examination, the size of ulcer, 4 cm x 4 cm, with a depth of 5 cm, the margins are punched out and the floor is by necrotizing bone. There is no sensation. A sterile scoop was introduced during dressing and necrotized bone was scooped out without anesthesia. Understand, we never used any anesthesia to bring out. He used to keep his leg like that and sit quietly. There was also another small ulcer present near the medial aspect of the foot. Okay, this is where it's the ulcer. And the diagnosis, post-paraplegic tropical ulcer. What you would like to do? Okay, anybody? Chat box, you can come. Lachesis. Yeah, help herself. Calibichromicum, fluoric acid, Mersal, Ledampol, Silesia, nitric acid. Good, all the things are good. So let us see what we have done. Okay, with the presentation, initially we have tried out a fluoric acid 30 was given for 2 days, followed by aura metallicum. There was no progress. The offensiveness was still continuing, so thought of reconsidering that. See, as far as myself is concerned, if there is an improvement is expected, especially in ulcer, the first thing what has to come down is the offensiveness has to come down. That shows that the infection is under control. So there was no offensiveness was not under control. So I thought that these medicines are not working. So I went ahead with understanding of the miasm. The miasmatic interpretation was given as syphilitic miasm because of the punched out ulcers and the necrosis of a bone. On 21-9, the case was given Mersal 0/6 TDS, and following this, offensiveness has drastically reduced within 2 days. Mersal was continued for another 5 months in 0/12 and 0/30 potencies. And finally, see what we have done. See, this is a very good example because when he has approached a surgeon, he has told it will never heal for you because there is no sensation for you and there is no nerves for you. So it will never heal. So better if you want to get yourself amputated. So that's what is the situation. And now this is where it has healed. And now he has taken up a job of auto driving. Okay, he brings so many patients by his auto to our institution. Later on, sulfur was given as a constitutional remedy. With that, the patient had even improvement in the incontinence of urine and prolapse of rectum. So the remedy fluoric acid and RMET were immediately withdrawn as there was no relief. The first and foremost sign of improvement in such a type of ulcer is the offensiveness has to get diminished. Merzol was selected in the case after defining the miasm and also diagnosis as trophic ulcer. Boger in his synoptic writes that Merzol is indicated in painless ulcers after damages to nerve. So whenever we understand the pathology of trophic ulcer, it resembles what Boger has narrated. Along with that, the other symptoms of offensiveness and the lordaceous base due to the necrotizing bones was considered, and immediately offensiveness was reduced, which is an indication of that infection is under control. The wound was also dressed with calendula glycerin, and in later stages after complete granulation, a laser therapy was used to have a faster epithelialization and keratinization. So this was advised by one of our physiotherapists because a laser light was just, beam was passed over his ulcer. And this is a third case. Mr. A, aged 63 years, he presented with a complaint of non-healing multiple ulcer for a period of 4 years over the left leg in the calf region. There used to be occasional burning and a watery sticky discharge. Multiple ulcers were there. Since 3 days, patient has also developed itching all over the body with the burning, which is aggravated by early morning 3 to 4 a.m. and aggravated by warmth and sweating and ameliorated by cold bathing. He is also having burning micturition. Patient has got also fullness of abdomen, which is aggravated with eating as soon as. For the ulcer, he has taken allopathic and Ayurvedic treatment, which gives a temporary relief, but not completely cured. He has also been given taking treatment for hypertension and for knee pain. And 5 years back, patient had an attack of chikungunya. And the patient as a person, very fastidious, cooperative, very proud, easily angered, anxiety of the disease about, aggravated by contradiction and magnetized, there is a desire to be, desires open air, desires cold food and drink. Physical examination, joint is nil and everything is nil, and ulcer, multiple ulcers in the left leg, 6 in numbers, base, muscle, and the floor had a dark blackish colored granules. No pain and no localized lymphadenopathy. Lab investigation was this. And you see there is a KOH mount of the ulcer slough revealed fungal hyphae. So this is nothing but a mycetoma, a fungal infection or fungal ulcer, which is known as a mycetoma. So the following totality was taken up: mind, company desire for, mind fastidious, mind hearty, contradiction intolerant of, general food and drinks, cold water ameliorate, skin itching, burning, itching, scratching ameliorates, and skin ulcer, painless ulcer, fungus. Okay, the medicine which have come up, sepia, phosphorus, arsenicum, lycopodium, sulfur, lachesis. Finally, arsenic album was selected and was given in 0/3 potency and was repeated for a period from 38/2010 to 39/2011. Then the potency was raised. And this is what you are seeing. Okay. And finally, we could get that presentation like this. It got healed, mycetoma of foot. And the case number 4. So this was a person who is 41-year-old male. And he presented with the right lower extremity since 1.5 months. There was an ulcer, painful and oozing. Started with a reddish discoloration. Then the blister formed. The complaint started after a fever, and that ulcer pain is first aggravated by movement, first movement, aggravated by exertion and ameliorated by rest. History of presenting illness. Patient had a fever and chilliness 1.5 months back. Along with this, he has developed a redness and swelling of the leg. Consulted in an allopathic hospital where they did surgery and the patient developed ulcer. He was treated and then advised by the doctor to undergo skin grafting. Very interesting. This fellow is one who sits at the taluk office and write memorandums or some sort of that work and get income out of that and lives. So he is financially very, very poor. So he was taken to a nearby hospital for his cellulitis. And I do not know what happened. That surgeon did some sort of thing. And within 10 days, he has to pay an amount of 1 lakh rupees. After that, the surgeon told he was given dressing. And then the surgeon told, see, your thing has to get healed. For that purpose, we have to take the skin from your thigh and apply it on your ulcer. And it requires another 1 lakh rupees. Come with that, we will take care of you. Already this person is under debt. So he came to us. And appetite normal, thirst normal, stool regular, and urine normal, sweat normal, sleep good. Mental state is easily anchored. He desires company, introvert, very irritable, fastidious, and worried about the financial problem. The reactions, he desires sour and spicy thing, and he desires fanning and summer and cold bathing. This is a general. Okay, usually this is a presentation. And he has a habit of cigarette smoking 6 per day and alcohol once in a week. And this is a final findings. Anemic and mild pallor was there. And all the things are like this. Ulcer examination, see that, how much it is. Ulcer of 13 × 11 cm extending from the malleolus above. Edges are punched out, floor with the granulation tissue, base is the bone. See, you see how much big that ulcer is and how depth that ulcer is. See, this is the area you can see that, it is a pulsating. Okay, in this area you will be able to see a pulsation. That means the anterior tibial artery is giving rise to the pulsation. So directly that anterior tibial artery, you can see that in this area. Okay. And see that artery. and see the depth of that ulcer. How do you want? Anybody? Please let me see the chat box. How do you want to manage? Arsenicum, fluoric acid. Yes, sifalinum, very good. Lachesis, yes. Nitric acid, arsenic album, MRSAL. Yeah. See, very interestingly, this case had a very sensitive. He will not even allow us to use a cotton and dress it up. Okay. So now, yeah, please. Somebody raise the hand. Okay. See that ulcer after homeopathic treatment. You are able to see how, you know, from that big ulcer to small it is becoming. And this is finally what we have produced without 1 lakh rupee. Okay. Huh? This is what homeopathy can offer. How much, you know, maybe it could not even, you know, 10,000 for him. Not even 10,000 for him. Because we give it as a very reduced cost. Okay, this is what we have done. Initially, there was no presentation at all. So I took it as a cellulitis. Cellulitis, then the surgeon did something for the cellulitis and the patient has given, patient has come up with an ulcer. So I started the prescription as a Rustox because this is one of a good remedy for, cellulitis. So now on 8th, there was increased pus formation and so sensitive. Patient felt the pain, even the dressing cotton touches the wound. So we have gone ahead with changing that medicine to Heparcel. And then it was continued for some time. And on 16-2-2009, the picture changes. So I opened the ulcer. There was so profuse bleeding and the sensitiveness remains the same. So now there is a shift from my prescription from sensitivity remains, but the pathology changes. So where you had a sensitiveness plus pus formation, it was Heparcel. And sensitive remains the same. Now the granulations start to bleed. That medicine was changed to Lachesis. Okay. And 23-3, the ulcer has completely healed, which you have seen. Okay. So now the presenting complaint of another case is, a man who is aged 62 years, male patient came to our OP for the complaints of large non-healing offensive ulcer. Duration is for 7 years. Okay, please understand that duration is for 7 years, which appeared after surgical removal of his right second toe. His signs and symptom was massive ulceration with pain, oozing of blood sometimes with the offensive watery discharge, and pain was aggravated by walking. Patient also had a burning pain accompanied with the numbness of the surrounding area. The ulcer was irregular in shape. Patient also complained of recurrent spraining of the ankles. He has got also itching of the anus. And history of presenting complaint. 7 years before, patient was apparently normal. Complaints started gradually and the patient was known to be a diabetic and was under diabetic treatment. Ulcer started in the first toe and the toe was removed surgically, yet the ulcer has not healed. History of previous illness with the treatment adapted. Known to be diabetic more than 7 years, taking allopathic treatment. Known to be hypertensive since 18 years, taking allopathic treatment. History of hemorrhoids before 30 years, took allopathic and homeopathic treatment. And family history, no relevant family history or it was not elicited. General features, he has got appetite normal, stool regular and satisfied, thirst normal, urine regular and satisfied, sleep good, sweat increased generally. Reaction to desire cold food, cold climate and fanning he desires. Mental generals, he has altered mental disposition that he does not desire to do any work, indifferent he is. Okay, these are the investigation which has been done. And see, this is the ulcer. Anybody from the finding, what is this ulcer? From that appearance, anybody who can, what is that ulcer? Could you? Okay. This type of ulcer, whether you have seen somewhere? An epithelial ulcer over, amputated site. Right. So repertorial totality was taken up. Extremity pain, burning, foot sore. Okay. This was a case of a Marjoni's ulcer. It's sort of a malignant ulcer which develops over a keloid. Marjoni's ulcer. Okay, so this was a totality which was taken up and this was a repertorization. Boric repertorization was done. And repertorial result was carbovich, sepia, arsenic album and phosphorus, and we have started that case like this and later like this and finally like this. Okay, I don't say that it is a cure, but where we could reduce the ulcer, Marjoni's ulcer. Okay, so finally ulcer which requires these type of approach. Okay, either you have to do a constitutional approach or you have to go ahead with a phase, you have to take a phase approach, or you take out a pathological, prescription and go ahead, or change your remedy according to what is the presentation. There is nothing like you sticking onto a single remedy and you can produce all the result. I have also put it as once a constitutional remedy was given, another was a phase remedy was given, a pathological prescription was done, and then we have also changed according to presentation. Epersulf was given, then we have changed to what you call lachesis. And finally, we have produced the palliation. Okay. And what is important is how do you select the simulimum? Simulimum is the important, whether the simulimum can be at these all stages, simulimum at a constitution level, simulimum at a phase level, or simulimum at a pathological level, or simulimum depending upon the presentation. No, the presentation can change. And you can change also the remedy and similimum at a palliative level. And the more important thing, okay, apart from you producing a cysts, you know, you bringing to a simulimum, the accessory management is very important in ulcer management. So wound debridement is very, very important. When there is a slough, when there is, you know, a lot of gangrenous material, of course, you need to, you know, trim it. You need to cut and remove all that slough, and you need to, you know, dress it properly. And with your, you know, antibactericidal agents, what we have homeopathically, either with calendula or echinacea. Now, again, there is a small difference is there. How do you take whether it is calendula or echinacea? Echinacea is taken when the infection is more. Okay, echinacea external application is given when the infection is more. To reduce the infection, you can give echinacea glycerin. And if you want to promote that you want to promote that granulation tissue, you go ahead with giving calendula as a reason. And apart from this, you know, diabetic management is also important. Whenever the patient is on anti-diabetic drugs, allow him to continue, because we do not know how it is going to react. We do not know. So that's why whenever the patient is on insulin, you can allow them to have the insulin. Okay, no problem. But only thing, strict monitoring has to be there, you know. Fortunately, we have got a surgeon with us who comes for our treatment. He's the one who regulates the insulin for us. We don't directly involve. We allow him to regulate the insulin. And very important is the diet and regimen. Okay. So preferably a diet which is very rich with the sprouts, with the green salads, and with the protein is very good for that management of the ulcers. Okay. So now next few minutes, we'll go for our discussion. You can allow them to speak, Dr. Shiva Prasad. So if they have any questions, let them raise the questions and I will answer for.
Yeah, technical team, Dr. Suraj, Sebastian, you can unmute.
Yes, sir. If raise hand questions can be allowed, sir, if that is.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you can please, those who have questions, please raise your hand so that Dr. Suraj will unmute you. You can also look into the chat box also, people will do.
Yeah.
Yeah, whether antibiotica of painkillers were okay, so many questions are there. Let us go ahead. One by one, I will go ahead. Proportion of echinacea with glycerin, that is the first question. Yes, 1:10. 1:10 is a proportion, which is what I have done. I do not know what the pharmacy says. 1:10 is a proportion in which I used to take. Cesium mother tincture for diabetic ulcer, long-standing ulcer external application. I have heard a few of my fellow doctors are trying that. Cesium, but I don't have a direct experience with cesium. Oh, sir, the basis of potency selection. Yeah, this is a very good question. See, almost all the cases I've used zero bar potency or what you call 50 millisimal potency, because this is the one where you have control over your reputation. So that's what I use many of the time. Not only in my ulcer treatment, even my homeopathic other treatment also, I use zero bar potencies. Okay. So now once I start with the zero bar one, then I go to zero bar two. But usually this is not available. Zero bar two is not available. So I go for 0 bar 3, 0 bar 6, 0 bar 12, like that. Whatever available potency, I use it to 50 millisimal because, you know, least aggravation is there and the most result is there. Whether antibiotics, painkillers were allowed to during homeopathic treatment? No, no, no. I have not this one. TAO, our scope. Of course, we have a lot of scope with TAO. Okay. Yeah. Now, varicose ulcer, a medicine in which potency is good and we have repeated done. Sorry, I couldn't present you a varicose ulcer case. We have so many. Okay, good cases. And my main remedies, again, remedies are like, you know, whatever have vascular affection, especially vein. Of course, you know, the first and foremost remedy is lacasis. You know, Vipera is there. And again, arsenicum is also there. Carbo animalis is there. Carbo vegetabilis is there. Okay. So these all things were there, were the medicines. And of course, there was a case of calcarea fluor was also given, where there was a varicose ulcer. Okay. And okay. See, yeah, sir, can we find any change in Doppler artery and venous after treatment? Definitely there are changes. Definitely there are changes. Okay, which is not a part of our this one. We are going for a, now recently we have done a research on that itself, physiotherometer that we are using that. And of course, Doppler study was also done. We have seen so much of improvement. Yeah. This is again ulcer characteristic of differentiation in psora, syphilis, psychosis, and tubercular miasm. Okay, many of the time I don't find psoric ulcers, either psychotic ulcers or syphilitic ulcers or tubercular ulcers. Psoric ulcers, they heal so fast. Any ulcer which heals fastest, as far as myself, is psoric ulcer. Psychotic ulcers, of course, psychotic ulcers are the one which, very slow healing, and you won't get much of offensiveness. The ulcer remains like that. And lot of, rather than it affects the bone, it affects the musculature. And sometimes you get a proud flesh. Overgrowth is there. So that is a psychotic ulcer. And syphilitic ulcer and tubercular ulcers. Tubercular ulcers, they have a lot of, fibrotic healing. Okay, we have seen some of these, ulcers, especially that varicose ulcers, they heal with the fibrosis. Some area of fibrosis were there and some area of ulcer would be there. And syphilitic ulcer, punched out ulcer, you will be able to see up to the bones, what you have seen in that, second case. Okay, that is a syphilitic ulcer. Okay, then how do you use dispenser 50 millisimil medicine and how often you repeat it? Yes, 50 millisimil medicines we give in lactose dose. Okay, you give a single dose and ask the person to dissolve it in water. Okay, either 3 spoons, if you want to give 3 doses, 3 spoonful water and dissolve it and take it as a 3 times. So the next morning, another 3 spoonful will be put and you add 1 dose. That's how we dispense. We don't dispense it in water. We give them the dose and ask them to take it in water. They dissolve it in water, 3 spoons of water, and then they take, or 4 spoons of water. Okay, like that, how we give. And how often we repeat. Sometimes even in very acute cases, where that sensitiveness is very high, 50 millisimil, even at a 2-hour interval, I repeat. Okay, next question. Sir, if patient is hypertensive and diabetic, whether you allow them to take allopathic medicine during... Yes, I do allow them to take allopathic medicines because already they have been for a long time. Okay, and you are not defined their constitution. Don't withdraw their drug. Okay. And somebody asks, what is the difference between simulimum? Simulimum and phase. Somebody asked. Okay. See, simulimum means the correspondence of symptom. Okay. That correspondence of symptom can be at various level. It could be simulimum could be at the constitutional level. Okay. Simulimum could be at the constitutional level. It will be suitable for the person both, predisposition, dispositionally, both at the mental disposition, physical disposition, and diathesis which is suitable, and then the disease wise. So everything will be suiting for him. That is a constitutional simulimum. Okay, right. Next is, you can have simulimum either at a mental level or at a physical level, only to a particular area. So this is known as for a particular period of time, it is a phase. So simulimum could be at that phase. Or you will never get these all things. All the things will be going off. Patient is at a very end advanced pathological changes. No constitution would be available. No phase will be available. What is available for you is only the pathology and the pathological effect. So your simulimum has to be at that level. Okay, please, those who has understood. Okay, those who has asked that question, please understand this. Okay, right. Fluoric acid and nitric acid in management of ulcer. Yes, we had cases of fluoric acid also, nitric acid ulcers, both we have. So we will take up that differentiation in a separate this one whenever possible. All right, sir. All right. Cecal core practical application. Cecal core practical application, I have seen in elderly who is having what you call senile ulcers. There are cases where I have been, consultant for one old age home where you get a senile ulcers, okay, due to that age. So that cases which I have seen responding for cecal core very much. Yeah. Okay, Lachesis and comparison. See, the Lachesis and Vipera, both are good for, especially varicose ulcers. So when varicose ulcer does not heal with Lachesis, I go for Vipera. Not Vipera which does not heal, I go for Lachesis. First would be Lachesis. If they are not responding for Lachesis, if it is not responding for Lachesis, I go for Vipera. Okay. Right. And typical symptom is there, Yeah, carbo-animalis is a medicine. Of course, carbo-animalis is a medicine for varicose ulcer and a very, very long-standing varicose ulcer with fibrosis and non-healing. Okay. There would be some cases where there would be a lot of fibrosis and that cases respond for carbo-animalis. Vinita, Dr. Vinita has asked that question. Yeah. So, and of course, my potency, I have already told, I would prefer a 50 millisimal potency. Yeah, Dr. Suresh, any other things people would like to, if they want, you just allow them. Otherwise, okay.
I think one person has raised their hand, sir. We have given the unmute option also. I think they are not asked. I think Dr. Haripriya.
Yes, put anything on the chat box. Because we have another half an hour, we can go ahead with discussing something else also. Dr. Haripriya, if you have any question, please put up. There is one question. What about the management of diabetes level during the treatment, sir, apart from semaglutide? Yes, I have already told that whatever, if the patient is on insulin, we allow them to have the insulin. And there were cases where insulin has been also withdrawn. Okay, we have so many cases. There has been also cases where we have withdrawn the insulin. So that is also there. Explain few important drugs as it is a differentiation practically. So now practically, if you want to, first you have to understand whether, ulcers are sensitive or non-sensitive. Okay, you define first ulcers which are sensitive, like carbavechi, which is not much sensitive. And then like Heparcel is a sensitive. Lachesis is sensitive ulcers. Aura metallicum is a non-sensitive ulcer. Mersal is not a sensitive ulcer. So first thing, you have to differentiate whether sensitive. Nitric acid is a very sensitive ulcer, both at the mind and body. So you have to differentiate whether it is sensitive, non-sensitive. You divide that. Next is you take whether it is offensive or not offensive. Okay, like your arsenic album, Mersal, fluoric acid, they are very offensive ulcers. Okay, and cecal cor is offensive. Like carbavech and other remedies like carbo animalis and carbavech, they are not much offensive. Okay, then what is a sensitive offensiveness? Then you have to also see what is the base of the ulcer, whether it is like bones. When it will like becomes bones, you have like aura metallicum, fluoric acid, nitric acid, they become lardaceous base, they Mersal, they become what is a base. Like you have your muscles. Okay, then you have calendula. Calendula is also good remedy for calendula, Heparcel. They become very important. So like that you can differentiate. Later on I will be able to give you a chart like that also. Any other questions, please? There was a, can you guide us from simple abscess ulcer to chronic malignant ulcer? See, this is what I have done. What I have done is, I have traveled from simple ulcer, a traumatic ulcer, to a arterial ulcer, to a malignant ulcer. I have traveled and I have also told how do I select a medicine. And difficulties, blocks in your practice. Oh, that is so many are there. So many are there. Kamath. Thank you, Kamath, for patiently listening to me. And somebody asked for how many days the remedy will be given for cases, sir. That depends upon the case. We have even, from 1 month to 6 months we have treated, and there was another very diabetic case, it went for 1 year treatment. That is one of our students' mother. She underwent for 1 year because the only solution was amputation, which they don't want to do. So she was on homeopathic treatment. Nearly 8 months she was admitted in the hospital. Okay, so that is, we cannot predict the time. Chronic ulcers, oral cavity, especially toward Malignant ulcers. Yes, of course, we do have so many malignant ulcers. And we have cases like arsenic album was prescribed, calicinatum was prescribed. Okay, so many things were there. Can you get us? Okay, sir, experience of squamous cell carcinoma ulcer. Yes, see that Marjoni's ulcer is a squamous cell carcinoma. And, you know, we also had other squamous cell carcinoma of tongue was there. Again, that was given as arsenicum album was given. Okay, and arsenic album is one of the good remedy for squamous cell carcinoma, wherever it may be. Sir, what about homeopathic specific remedies for particular condition? Can they be? Yes, I'm not a very, very classical homeopath, the so-called classical homeopath. Homeopathy has to treat in different manner. Okay, that's what. You know, you cannot stick on only if I have the rare, uncommon, peculiar, or, you know, the so-called, you know. Homeopathy, you have to use it at depending upon what stage this disease is coming. Wherever you have to use specific medicine, use specific medicine. Wherever you have to use face medicine, use face medicine. Wherever you have to use the constitutional medicine, you have to use constitutional medicine. It is not the homeopath that decides what medicine has to be. It's the case has to decide which medicine has to be given. Okay. All right. Sir, when to give intercurrent remedy while treating ulcers and with the potency is preferable. Okay, one of my experience with 50 millisimal potency, you know, I do not know, I don't have much time I have to use an intercurrent remedy in ulcers. Okay, but there are cases where, you know, other conditions where I have used intercurrent remedies, especially asthma and all, you know, in spite of 50 millisimal potency, you have to use either psychotic as an psychotic intercurrent or tubercular intercurrent. We need to use role of external application in treating chronic cases. Yes, to certain extent, this is important. You need to put two way it helps. As an external protection, and internally the patient will also feel, yeah, because this is a routine practice that the surgeon applies so much of ointment, and you know, you have to give an internal satisfaction for the patient. Of course, there are cases where we have used just applied a sterile pad and sent, but that will not give a satisfaction for the patient. So you have to use some sort of glycerin. If you apply, the patient would be so happy. So that's what is a preference is given. And of course, our some of these medicines, they are antibacterial. So they provide, apart from internal medicines, external medicines will also give relief. So I don't restrict. No, I'm giving an internal medicine and external would interact with it. I'm not that classical. Okay, that is okay. Diabetic ulcer, depending upon it is taken me back to his classroom. Who is that AC? I don't remember this. Who is this AC? It has taken me back to his classroom from 2002. I'm probably one of my student. Okay. Is there any recurrence of the ulcer from this patient? No, none of this patient whom I have given you in this, they did not have that recurrence. Okay. Yeah, I already told TAO. 30th potency and LM potency. Here is using Q as a local application. Okay, Atul, yeah. Atul, now I understand. Okay, thank you, Atul. Yeah. So, hope so. Any other formalities? We have come up for 15 minutes. Now, next formality shall we go for?
You have to present anything, Winston?
No, almost I have finished. If people want anything, I can go ahead. I have a few more slides are there. Now I have to search and present if they want it. Another 15 minutes, no? You have your procedures.
Oh, yeah, 15 minutes, yeah. We are finishing now because you had an interaction along with your presentation. It's quite nice because they can clarify during that phase. So it's something well done by you because fear and the expectations. Fear is from the patient side and whether it can be cured by homeopathy. Expectation is again fear and expectation by the physicians also, whether we can do it. Because that is the modern trend is like that, the people get admitted and they get treated. And then it is a matter of pinching the pocket. But as homeopaths, we need to have patience. We need to have, you know, explanations to what we do. And for that, the physician should be having that strong determination to give a clarification to, you know, patients' queries. I think Dr. Winston Varghese has given exposition by a good number of cases, what he has come across in his clinical practice. And that is what his passion for treating ulcers, where we require a lot of patients. So that is what Winston is known for, sustainability and maintaining his abilities. And in fact, one of the things where he is also good at it is life space investigation exposition. Whatever we have seen in the cases, he has you know, condensed that part of it and he has come out with the mental and you know, mental symptoms, because those are the converted into rubrics and could get a right remedy, because it is not an easy thing to collect those symptoms. Winston is the expert in this. And with all these things, yes, he made me to remember our Dr. M.L. Davali, because he has got a presentation style of sir. The tone in which he goes is what Dr. M.L. Davali also presents. So I'm reminded of those days, Dr. Winston Varghese. Thank you very much from my side and all of you for your information. The passion of him to Father Muller, his daughter is completing her internship this year. And that is another, you know, quality which I find trying to be in touch with Father Muller's. Thank you, Dr. Winston. And I will hand it over to Dr. Penny Vedevara for her final concluding remarks. Thank you.
Thank you so much for giving me an opportunity, Shiv. Once again, Shiv. Okay. And all the other organizers, thank you so much. And all my listeners who patiently listen to me, thank you so much. Thank you. Please, next.
It's my privilege to have been asked to propose a vote of thanks on this occasion. A big thank you to Dr. Winston Varghese on behalf of Father Muller Homeopathic Medical College and the entire team for gracing your important work and sharing with us your knowledge. I thank today's moderator, Dr. Shiv Prasad K. I also extend my thanks to Dr. Dheeraj and team and all the technical staff for organizing this event. Dear delegates, we will soon be having a session by Dr. Sajeev Lazar on Medicina Hanumania at 7:30. Have a great day. Thank you.